Tiffany, and this is my channel, Hoosier Handmade. Thank you so much for stopping by today. In today's video, we're talking all about sewing machines. I've been tagged in the YouTube tag, hashtag sewing machines must-haves, and today we're gonna talk about my requirements for the perfect sewing machine. So if that sounds interesting to you, stick around. If you are new to my channel, welcome. Thank you so much for stopping by. I hope that you will consider subscribing before you leave. I would love to get to know you better and welcome you into the sewing community. And thank you so much to each one of my friends who are tuning in again today. Thank you so much for taking time out of your day to spend it with me. It means so very much to me, you guys. Thank you for your friendship and your support. So in today's video, we are talking about sewing machines. Michelle from Michelle Sews Again started the hashtag sewing machines must-haves kind of tagging challenge here for the sewing community. Her intent, I believe, was to see what we loved about sewing machines, what we looked for when we were picking out our own sewing machine so that it would help her in her journey toward a new sewing machine. So I don't know if Michelle has picked out a new sewing machine yet. I'm kind of behind, I've been moving. So it's taken me a little bit to get this video out, but I was tagged by the lovely Agatha from In Agatha's Cottage. She is a dear sewing friend. I met her through this wonderful YouTube community. We talk a lot. I love chatting with her. She has a wonderful channel. I will link it down below. Don't forget to go check her out. And Agatha very graciously tagged me and wanted to know what my sewing machine must-haves was. So Agatha has her own video. Like I said, she tagged me in it. So go check out her sewing machine must-haves video. I will link it down below as well. And let's see what my requirements were for a new machine. So I've been sewing garments for about 3 years now, but I actually started sewing 7 or 8 years ago with my mother in quilting. My mother is an exclusive quilter. She loves to quilt and she brought me to the dark side. And when I started learning how to quilt, I wanted a machine of my own. I was borrowing a few off of mom, but I had trouble figuring out how to thread them, how to wind a bobbin, etc., etc. So I wanted a machine for myself. So I took myself off to Walmart and did a little shopping. I bought a machine from Walmart, a Brother, I don't remember the number, you guys. I will pop a picture up of what my machine looks like. I still have that Brother machine. I love her dearly. I'm taking her to church group now and using that machine instead of lugging this big baby lock machine around. That was my beginning machine. I will always have a love for her. She is a great machine, and actually there was a lot of great features that I fell in love with on that Brother machine, and that's what led me in my search for my upgraded machine. Now this machine sitting beside me here is a Baby Lock Crescendo. You can no longer buy the Crescendo, but I'm still gonna talk about her. I believe it was replaced by the Chorus, the Baby Lock Chorus machine, if I'm wrong. Drop it down in the comments if you know for sure what machine replaced the Crescendo. They literally just retire one model and bring a new model out almost exactly like it, you guys. So you can't buy the Crescendo anymore from a dealer, but I've been seeing a lot of great ones online on Facebook Marketplace that individuals are trying to sell. So if you like this machine, maybe look around in your local Facebook Marketplaces and maybe you can find one. I'm still gonna talk about her because she has so many wonderful features that are indeed must-haves for me. This is my dream machine. But if I loved my Brother so much, why did I pursue a dream machine? So I was saving up my pennies for this machine, but why? So that Brother machine that I have is quite small. It is, it has a very small throat. This is the throat of your machine. That's what it's called right here. And it had a very small one. It was probably about 9 inches long, which is kind of small. I couldn't do bigger projects very very easily. I was really having to stuff them into the throat area. So the machine was small and it was also kind of clunky. Now she works wonderfully. She sews a stitch beautifully, but that Brother machine is loud and clunky. Even the other ladies on quilt retreat would comment to me a lot back in the day, "Tiffany, your machine is so loud." I know, I'm sorry. I don't really know why she is. I'm gonna take her into the shop and see if someone can look at that, but she still sews really, really well. So those minor kind of annoyances really kind of drove me to look for the dream machine after I had all my pennies saved up and could make it happen. So this is definitely my dream machine. Like I said, let's go over some features that I brought over from my Brother machine. Like I said, the throat was one that I was really looking for an upgrade in. This is 15 inches from the edge of my machine over to the inside of the throat, 15 inches. So that is a really wide throat right here. Also, my number one requirement that came from my Brother, I developed such a love for this, was the drop-in bobbin. So up here is how you put your bobbin in. You have the case that you clip off and then you drop your bobbin in. I love that. My Brother machine was just like that, so I was definitely looking for a top loading bobbin. I used my mom's Bernina for a little bit, and all Berninas except for the Bernettes, I believe the Bernettes are top loading, but the Berninas are front loading bobbins, and I absolutely hated loading the front bobbin. So when I was looking for sewing machines, if they started the conversation with front loading bobbin, my brain immediately turned off and and eliminated that machine from even the running, because I was not going to deal with a front loading bobbin every day. So the top loading bobbin was probably my number one requirement, honestly. Other things that this Crescendo came with that were extras were a lot of automatic functions. You have automatic back stitching, automatic thread cutting, automatic threading, and this one actually works. My Brother machine said that it would thread for me. It had the little tab that you pulled down. You had to hit it down. It would come, it would extend down here, and you would have to fiddle with it and try to get it to thread your machine. It never worked for me on my Brother. The baby lock works every time, knock on wood. She has not let me down with the automatic threading. The automatic back stitch is really useful. Going back to the Brother here a couple days ago, I was just kind of lost without all my automatic functions. You get used to it. If you're not used to it now, if you buy a machine like these, you will definitely get used to all those automatic functions very, very quickly. This machine also comes with a start and stop button, so you don't have to use the pedal necessarily. And I thought that that would be really, really useful when Addie starts to learn how to sew. I could use the start and stop button with her while she's still learning to the feel of the pedal, to learn how to use the pedal. So I thought that was a really great function. This machine comes with so many stitches. I was so impressed with all of the stitch functions. There are things over here that I have not even used, you guys. It has a sensor pen that I haven't even used. It has a laser. I have it on right now. Let me show you. There's a laser that comes out right here. This is a really neat function that I actually have used quite a bit. It's most useful in quilting, but I've used it in garment sewing as well. It's gonna help you stay on a straight line. It's a really nice guide. It keeps you straight every single time. An extra, I wasn't looking for the laser, but it's definitely an added bonus. This machine also comes with a walking foot, which is really, really impressive, because the walking foot for your machine can be very expensive, and most machines you have to buy them separately, but this machine actually came with the walking foot. It's very easy to attach, easy to use. I use it all the time, especially with knit garments, so I'm really, really happy with the walking foot that came with this one. It also came with like 13 regular feet, the regular feet that fit on here. So a lot of options with this machine. It really came with a great package. From my Brother machine, I got used to an automatic buttonhole, and this one does the same thing. I love that. I love all the automatic features. It's just a wonderful machine. So what what drew me to Baby Lock? So what drew me to Baby Lock is that I think, in my personal experience from owning a Brother machine, using it for several years, loving it, and now owning a Baby Lock, they are so similar. I cannot get, especially a dealer, to look me in the eye and tell me that Baby Lock and Brother are related. I can't get anyone to tell me that they're made by the same company or very like companies or anything like that. But to me, they are sister companies. They are so, so similar in functions. And I was very comfortable with that. I loved my Brother machine. I was very comfortable sewing it. And to me, these Baby Lock machines were so similar to the Brother that it was just, it's a big sister to the machine that I already had. So I was very used to sewing with it, very comfortable from the beginning. So that's why I went to the Baby Lock. So those are my top must-haves in a machine. Again, I'm not looking for a machine. This is it, you guys. She is the end all be all to me. I love her. She's my dream machine. I'm so blessed to have her. If you are in the market for a larger machine like this, just keep in mind, again, you cannot buy a Crescendo from a dealer anymore. They're not producing them. They're not making them. They do have very similar models, like I said, so you could go in and talk to the dealer and say, you know, what model replaced the Crescendo, and they can definitely show you what replaced it. Or again, look on Facebook Marketplace. There are people selling these machines, and I would highly recommend them. If you're on the fence and you found one for a very good deal from an individual, go for it. It's a great machine. I'm gonna have her for years to come. She's a workhorse. I work her. I sew with her almost every day, or I did before this crazy move. So she definitely gets the work in, and she's done such a great job for me. Again, thank you so much to Michelle for starting this wonderful tag. This was so much fun to talk about our machines. I could talk about her all day long, but I'll stop there. And thank you so much to Agatha for tagging me in her video and including me in this tagging challenge. Let me know down below what machine you love. To me, machines are like cars. We all have our preferences. We all have our certain brands that we love. No one size fits all, and that is totally fine. So let me know what brand you love, what machine you love, and what are some of your must-haves. I would love to know down in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. I will see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.